Hello, what's going on everybody? It's Easy Victus here with another oh yeah video for all of your animated show and movie related needs. Today my piece will be discussing who Aang's parents were from Avatar The Last Airbender, but of course there is no concrete evidence in any TV show or comic related to The Last Airbender that shows exact ages or names of his parents, etc. So I'll be making statements based off of what I can dig up or hypothesize about his parents. Right before we start, if you haven't checked out my Twitch channel, please do down below. I am starting to get together a schedule and it'll hopefully be together pretty soon. Everybody, let's just dive right into this video, okay? So we all know about Aang's children from Legend of Korra, which are Bumi, Kaya, and Tenzin. But what about Aang's parents? We never get a clear picture, actually whatsoever, of who Aang's mother and father were at all in Avatar The Last Airbender series, or where they were during his childhood he spent at the Southern Air Temple. So let's understand exactly the whole situation we're looking at here then. Whenever an airbender is born to the air nomads, they are taken from their parents and brought to a specific air temple. There are four air temples that a child could go to, which is either the West, North, South, or Eastern Air Temple. The Eastern and Western temples were reserved for women, while the Northern and Western temples were reserved for men. Each air temple had either monks or nuns that are there to tutor and act as parental figures for all of the children who are temporarily housed there. So Aang's parents had to have been air nomads, because they were the only kind of people who were able to have children with the ability to airbend. Aang was also born in 12 BG, which stands for Before Air Nomad Genocide. We can take from this that Aang's parents of course probably wanted to keep their beloved child, but weren't able to due to customs and tradition. They would have held the ideals of air nomads as well, which are very similar to modern day Buddhist monks and Taoism, believing in peace and tranquility between the nations and only using their bending as a form of defense, never offense. This would mean that his parents were most likely nice, gentle, and loving individuals who never hurt or wanted to hurt anyone. A fact that not many people know also is the fact that most air nomads didn't live in the air temples. Only the monks and nuns would make their permanent home here at these temples for the sake of passing on their ideals and way of life to the younger generation of airbenders. So Aang's parents would travel the world, living a life not sanctioned to one specific area, hence the term air nomad. Based off of Aang's own appearance and his children, I can make the following conclusions. His mother and father probably had dark brown or black hair, and had brown eyes, and a light skin tone. They were most likely in shape and healthy due to their air nomad customs and because they were always on the move, going from area to area and exploring the world, which takes a lot of energy. Probably also very funny, quick-witted, and had a good outlook on life just like Aang did. From the Legend of Korra, we can see Aang talking to Tenzin in the fog, and Aang is slightly shorter than Tenzin, and Tenzin is around Mako's height, which is 6'2", making Aang either 6'1" or 6'. So, Aang's parents were probably tall too. I would say the father would be from 6' to 6'3" in height, while the mother was most likely 5'8" to 5'10", with a muscular but slender build as well, which Aang and all of his children sport too. Even though Aang didn't have his biological parents there to guide him, he did have the monks, and his very good friend and father figure, Gyatso. He taught him everything he could about airbending, as well as patience and how to have fun. Without our Gyatso, Aang would have been a very different person, and for that, I thank him. You're awesome, Gyatso. And he's also powerful as hell, as we can see from how many firebenders he wasted away during the siege on the air temples. Like, he really had to have let loose to clap that many cheeks. So he's also a badass. So everybody, did you like the video? Did you sort of like it? Did you really hate it? Let me know in the comment section down below and tell me what you think about his parents. Do you think one thing about his parents? Do you think another thing about his parents? You let me know. Definitely down below. And if you haven't already, go ahead and check out my Twitch channel where I don't stream that much now, but my schedule is going to be up and running here in the next few months. So you all be the first to know. Also, stay notified when my next video comes out by clicking my big old noggin right there to subscribe to see when my next video comes out. I post every Tuesday and Friday, and sometimes I sprinkle a little bit in between, just randomly, and it's always about animated TV shows, but mostly Avatar The Last Airbender. And check out my last video here where I discuss what the most useful element is in Avatar The Last Airbender. Everyone, thank you so much for watching. Stay safe, and have a great day.